Listening Library presents She Persisted, Kalpana Chawla, by Raakhee Mirchandani and Chelsea Clinton. Inspired by She Persisted by Chelsea Clinton and Alexandra Boiger. Read for you by Poorna Jagannathan, with a letter written and read by Chelsea Clinton. For Kalpana Chawla, brave, passionate, and persistent, and for all the kids, like my curious Satya, she continues to inspire.
Dear reader, as Sally Ride and Marion Wright Edelman both powerfully said, you can't be what you can't see. When Sally Ride said that, she meant that it was hard to dream of being an astronaut like she was, or a doctor, or an athlete, or anything at all, if you didn't see someone like you who had already lived that dream. She especially was talking about seeing women in jobs that historically were held by men. I wrote the first She Persisted and the books that came after it because I wanted young girls and children of all genders to see women who worked hard to live their dreams. And I wanted all of us to see examples of persistence in the face of different challenges to help inspire us in our own lives. I'm so thrilled now to partner with the Sisterhood of Writers to bring longer, more in-depth versions of these stories of women's persistence and achievement to readers. I hope you enjoy these chapter books as much as I do and find them inspiring and empowering. And remember, if anyone ever tells you no, if anyone ever says your voice isn't important or your dreams are too big, remember these women. They persisted, and so should you. Warmly, Chelsea Clinton.
Chapter 1, Punjab Dreams. Kalpana Chawla was a celebrated NASA astronaut and the first Indian-American woman to go to space. But before orbiting Earth, little Kalpana loved making paper airplanes and watching planes fly overhead from the roof of her home in India. She was born on March 17, 1962, in Karnal, a town in the state of Haryana in India. Her mother, Sanjyoti, and her father, Banarasi Lal, lovingly called her Montu, a sweet nickname. She had two older sisters, Sunita and Deepa, and a big brother named Sanjay. And it wasn't until Montu was 3 years old and ready to go to school that she needed a real name, which she had never had before. She chose the name Kalpana herself. Kalpana means imagination in Hindi, one of the languages her family spoke. It was the perfect name for the smart, brave, and fearless Indian girl who spent many nights on the roof, sometimes sleeping on a charpai, a traditional woven bed, imagining herself flying through the sky. Her whole family knew about her passion for flight and airplanes. Years later, Kalpana's mom remembered her asking about the sun and the moon, eager to know more about what she saw in the sky. Her dad remembered Kalpana asking how planes worked. Her natural curiosity and questions were clues for her parents and teachers. Kalpana was exceptional. Karnal was a small town, but it had both an airport and a flying club, which is an organization that provides members with access to planes. Kalpana was lucky to live there. She often saw pushbuck airplanes, a type of Indian plane, and gliders in the sky above her hometown. She and Sanjay would ride their bikes to the Karnal airport to watch the small aircrafts take off and land. Once, her dad organized a plane ride for Kalpana to see Karnal from up in the sky. This was Kalpana's first time in the air. When she landed back on the ground, she couldn't stop tapping her foot with excitement. She loved flying. A hardworking and dedicated student, Kalpana made her mark and excelled in every classroom she sat in. When it was time to graduate, she set her sights on her next goal. Kalpana wanted to study aeronautical engineering, a field related to aircraft and spacecraft. It wasn't common for women to study engineering at that time, but Kalpana persisted. Applying to Punjab Engineering College in Chandigarh, a couple of hours from her family home. But after her interview, she was told that women don't major in aeronautical engineering and that she should try mechanical engineering instead. Someone at the college even tried to get her to change her mind about joining the engineering program at all. But Kalpana knew what she wanted to do. In 1978, she became the first woman to ever enroll in the school's aeronautical engineering program. There wasn't even a girl's dorm for her to stay in. Kalpana was determined to chase her dreams, and nothing and no one was going to stop her. Her room in the apartment she rented in Chandigarh was covered in images of airplanes, astronauts, and space shuttles. There was no denying her passion. Dr. S.C. Sharma, one of Kalpana's college professors, later noted that Kalpana was the kind of student who always sat in the front of the classroom. She wasn't afraid to ask questions, raising her hand high and making sure her voice was heard. The whole class benefited from having a smart, thoughtful person like Kalpana among them, pushing them all to be better students. Her time there went quickly, and in the summer of 1982, Kalpana graduated. She made history as the first woman to graduate from the school with a degree in aeronautical engineering. But that wasn't enough for her. Kalpana had her sights set on her next big goal, applying and being accepted to a master's degree program in the United States of America. Chapter 2, Texas Dreams. When Kalpana was accepted to three American universities, her father wasn't too excited about his daughter moving across the seas, far away from her home. But it was time for Kalpana to spread her wings. She wanted to keep studying aeronautical engineering.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.